Good evening. Welcome back to another Sunday Night Shave. Sorry for my prolonged absence. Let's see. So 2 weeks ago, my son was sick. Couldn't record that evening. And that following week, I had a really bad shave. I don't know if I had a bad razor or what was going on, but I've been dealing with some bleeding, profuse bleeding a couple of times. So that's why I've been not shaving. I think it's silly if you're going to have a shaving channel and have bad shaves. Been trying to shave as little as possible and been letting the cuts heal and my head kind of just get back to where I think I'm going to have a good shave. Did a live shave last Sunday night in the Rich Man Shaving Group. A lot of live shaves, a lot of information shared, products passed around between folks. Really good group to join if you're not already a member. Back in the bathroom tonight for another Sunday night shave. Show you the products I'll be using this evening. Going to be using Phoenix Artisan Accoutrements, Dapper Docs, Lilac, and Fig Shaving Soap. This is a great scent. I absolutely love this. Lilac and Fig. I really get the lilac. It really is a really strong floral scent to me. And really enjoy that. The reason we're going with this tonight, this was one of the shaving soaps I got for Christmas from my parents in this past week. A buddy of mine over at Before and After Shaves, James Bayer, he's also a member of the Rich Man Group. He had some stuff for sale, and he was selling the aftershave. So I picked that up from him, which really prompted me to do tonight's shave. So that's what we'll be using this evening. Already have the lather whipped up here. This will be the last time you see the green salsa bowl. I'm selling these now, so to say. I'll show off some of the ones I've made for some buddies of mine in the Rich Man Group. Still have the lines. I couldn't get the marker lines out, but I kind of spiraled this one around. Did a unique design with this one. Wasn't really sure how I wanted to do them. I don't want to do them all the same. I want them all to be a little bit different from each other. This will be the new bowl. I had some soap pressed in this one for loading my razor this evening. So this will be my lather bowl from here on out. The orange one. Orange is my favorite color. And I just had some of the soap pressed in the bottom of this. What I'm using is actually a sample that someone had sent me. I believe James sent me this. I think. I can't remember for sure, but I'm trying to use this sample up before I dig into the tub that Mom and Dad got me. But we've already got the lather whipped up, as you can see. Nice, nice lather. Scent is the same between the sample and the soap I got, so I don't feel bad for not using the big tub. So let me go ahead and get the head wet. Gonna be cutting out the actual shaving part, just trying to get the in between the passes. Gonna do a two-pass shave this evening. Still got some spots that are healing, so to say, from all the bad shaves I've had. So hopefully tonight we won't be bleeding. We'll be using the Red Tip tonight, the Red Tip Super Speed, with a brand new Voskhod blade. So hopefully we get a good shave tonight. All right, got the head wet. Turn the water off. Time to get some soap applied again. Just a great, great scent. I really enjoy the scent of this Dapper Doc. When I first got the sample, I fell in love with the smell. It's just a really great floral scent. And it's not floral feminine, so to say, because a lot of soaps are geared towards male or a female demographic, and you'll get some that are lather flying everywhere. You'll have some that are like, that if you smelled it, you're like, oh, that's a lady's scent. But this is not the case with Dapper Doc. I really enjoy the fig and lilac combination. Supposed to be a sort of a take on, just gonna get some of that lather and put it back in the brush. Supposed to be a take on maybe a Western style scent. I think Douglas Smythe knocked it out of the park. Knocked it out of the park with this scent. This is probably one of my top three scents. So, get the cream spread out here. Absolutely love it. And you don't need me to tell you how slick PAA soaps are. Gonna get a little bit more on the brush and get that spread on the neck. So we are all lathered up. It's been a few days since I shaved, so my hair is kind of making the lather look not so great, but it is a good lather, I can promise you that. So, red tip with a brand new Voskhod blade. We're gonna get this puppy started. I'll see you in between the passes. All right, that was the first pass. So we'll get the brush loaded back up here for round number two. So good so far. I've not seen any blood in the lather rinsed off from the brush or from the razor, so maybe that's a good sign for this evening. Like I said, I've had a few bad shaves. I've got a place right here on my neck that I cut last time I shaved. I was trying out some Persona Lab blue blades, and those were sent to me by a buddy in the Rich Man group. I'm not sure if they were just bad blades or if my skin just didn't like the blade. I'm not sure. But it seemed like I didn't have a really good shave with any of those blades. So the odds of getting that many bad blades are pretty low. So I don't think I'll be using Personas going forward, because I use different razors. I would probably revisit them if I wasn't as seasoned as I am, so to say. Not that there's not more to learn for me. I'm not acting in no way like I've been doing this for as long as some of you guys have. But I'm not a newbie, so to say. I've been doing this for a few years, so I don't really see my technique getting much better. The only thing that may make a difference is maybe using it in another razor, but like I said, I've used them in my Slim Adjustable on different settings. I used it in the Red Tip. I used it in the Travel Tech. So I don't really see those working out for me in the future, so I probably won't use those again. But never say never. Never, ever say never. Let's rinse my hand off here. All right, so we'll get this slicked over. And we'll go in for pass number two. Like I said, just doing the two passes this evening, not looking for BBS or anything. Just trying to knock the growth down. All right. Again, the scent on this soap is amazing. Like I said, he was trying to base it on maybe sort of an old Western scents. I don't know if he found notes or maybe articles or something talking about scents they would have had. But as far as the scent notes are concerned, it's a fantastic floral note. Not too sweet. Just really florally. I really enjoy it. There's just something about the combination of the lilac and the fig that I just enjoy it a whole lot. So great soap. If you've not tried it out, get you a tub at Phoenix Artisan Accoutrements. All right, we'll turn the water on and I'll catch you after this pass. So rinse the head in cold water. Got all that rinsed off. And I'll tell you what, I think I've got one tiny weeper in the back. No, I've got a big one somewhere. But as far as smoothness is concerned, like I said, I only did two passes. I didn't do a touch-up or anything. No camera trickery tonight. Because sometimes I tell you I'm going to do X amount of passes and do a cut and then do touch-ups. And I didn't do that tonight. And it turned out pretty smooth. Smoother than I anticipated. Voskhods are usually pretty docile. They're usually they're on the smoother side of the scale. I'm not sure off the top of my head what the smoothest might be. I know a feather is the sharpest you can get, but I'm not sure about the smoothest. But as far as in between sharp, sharp and dull, dull, Voskhod's somewhere on the smoother side of the spectrum, but still great shaves. I get a fantastic shave with them. Actually, my dad, who I bought him a Black Beauty for his birthday, same year. I didn't get the same quarter because I'm an idiot, but I got the same year for him, and he sent that off and had that one revamped by Razor Emporium, and he actually just recently purchased a 50 pack of Voskhods because that's his favorite blade. He bought a sampler pack, I guess, off Amazon, and Voskhods were his favorite, so he's bought him a 50 pack of those. I keep looking right there because they're hanging on the wall next to you, right to your that direction, whatever, right or left, whatever that is for you. I record with the front facing camera, so I don't know which way's which. This is my left. So to my right is where those are at. So gonna do witch hazel tonight. I've made a purchase this week before last, last weekend actually. And I got me an Avon aftershave bottle. It was empty when I got it. I rinsed it out and I put all of my witch hazel in it. And what it is, let me put the head on there correctly. It's a bald eagle. Isn't that magnificent? I love it. Got some logs here and the bald eagle sitting on there. That's his legs. I took the lid off. And I've got all my witch hazel in this. So we're going to do witch hazel. So let me show you how good this bottle is. It holds a suction until you decide that you want to dispense it out. And I love that. I love how good the dispenser is on that bottle. And what I've done, I poured the rest of my witch hazel in it. So it's got my coconut water by Thayer's that I had the isopropyl alcohol in. And it's got the rest of my sterling lemon chill in it. The lemon chill witch hazel. No burning. Absolutely no burning whatsoever. That's a win in my book. No blood on the hands. So I think I sealed up that cut maybe. But we'll let that air out for a second. Got a little menthol in there, I think. The lemon chill has the menthol in it, so that's what it is. So let me lid that back up. Yeah, it's got just a tiny little lid. And then this sits on top. Isn't that awesome? You can get these on eBay. I've seen them for like $3, $5, $9. I seen one for $3, I seen one for $5, I seen one for $9. It's a great use for an old aftershave bottle. This was the, let me show you here. How much did I pay for this one? $3. I paid $3 for this one. But this was Avon. Let me see if I can peel the sticker off from where I purchased it. There we go. Avon Oland, I'm not sure how that's pronounced, aftershave. Didn't really have much of a scent in the bottle, so I don't know how long it had been without a lid sitting on it. But they make great aftershave bottles. If you're looking to put maybe your witch hazel, or maybe you've purchased like a modern brood or a modern aquavelve and you're looking for a bottle, go online and find you old glass decanters. Like I said, Avon has some. I know Old Spice, you can find some Old Spice decanters online. Those are good as well. All right, so the last product we'll be using, again, is the Dapper Doc Aftershave. Now this one, the aftershave smells almost identical to the soap. Sometimes you'll buy a soap and an aftershave, and the soap will, if it has two or three different notes, you may get a stronger side of the spectrum than the other one. For example, with the coconut lime soap and poche balm that I have from Sterling, the soap, I get them almost equally, the lime and the coconut. And then the poche balm, I smell more of the lime than the coconut. The coconut is still there, but it kind of takes a back seat to the lime. But in the soap, you get them about equally. Like, one second you'll be smelling coconut, one second you'll be smelling lime. But this is pretty much dead on with the soap. So great for me. So we'll just dispense some of that out. Oh, there's some burn. Not too much. A little more. Now, with this aftershave, I need to do some further testing, but I've used this aftershave once already, and I still smelled the aftershave the following day at work. Typically, I shave at night, I don't typically get up in the mornings and shave, so I shave at night, so all my products go on at night. I didn't reapply any. Oh, it smells amazing. It smells absolutely fantastic. Again, if you've not tried the Dapper Doc by PAA, get you a sample vial at the very least. Next time you make an order from them, get a little 99 cent vial, try it out. I promise you're gonna love it. But I still smelled this the next day at work. It wasn't super strong, but it was still there enough that I was getting whiffs of it all day. So, great product. Hope you've enjoyed tonight's shave, and we'll see you next Sunday night.